Good evening, ladies and gentlemen present today. Thank you. Welcome to this what do you call? How many real sabah? And thank you to moderator Webby, Tim Kichang, Saudara Kichang, Saudara Song Leong, and Saudara Rafizi Ramli. YB, one of them from Sarawak, right? Just in front of us. So, I never expected that I was asked to, you know, be one of the panel. But then, what actually I wanted to say is already being said by my DAP chairman, Kota Kinabalu. But anyway, to you all, well, I'm sure you remember. Where is Sabah? It's known as a popular one, it's not Borneo. If we go Europe or what, they never know where is Sabah. So if you talk about not Borneo, certainly they said, oh yeah. That is one of the, you know, the British colony territory. So anyway, I am not going much further on the real figure of the Sabahan people, real Sabahan people, which one of our fellow who's expert in this as what YBN Jimmy said, this yang berbahagia Dr. Chong Eng Leong, which he has been doing for long time since during Perjaya or what, and when he mentioned about the illegal immigrant. So our election commission by the name of Abdul Rashid. So he was telling him that cerita kadai kopi. See, he was named cerita kadai kopi. When we are talking about the right of Sabah, electoral, he said this is cerita kadai kopi. So but then this fellow being transferred, instead of being transferred, observed what he is being promoted to be the chairman of the election commission, right? So these are the things we are Sabah trying. Actually, what Semenanjung, saudara Semenanjung, never feel how is Sabah people when entering into the Federation of Malaysia. I still remember, because now I am 60 over years old, so Sabah is only 52, okay, years in Federation of Malaysia. So ever, during the time, I am very naive and I don't know what is politics. You know, I don't know. So because during the time, we don't know what is economy, what is Sabah look like during the time. Well, thinking of our, you know, well-versed leaders, right from Donald Stephen, Sundam, J.S. Sundam, you remember? Of course, Datuk Hari Saleh, who we call now is, you know, Ayam Tua. Oh yeah? He started this thing, you know, during most of the time. And if Mahathir is one of the, you know, the longest prime minister, but I can tell you Datuk Harris is the longest leader in Sabah. Even now, keep on talking. Yeah. But when I am referring, because this book is only given to me 3 days ago, so I have no chance to read. But when I look at Datuk Harris, and our Huguan Chiu himself, Jeffrey Kittingan, Madius Tangau, Wilfred Bumburi, what these people have been doing for Sabah. In the first place, what is Sabah, Sarawak, and Malaya supposed to be? It's three partnership, right? We are three partnership. We are not one of the 13. You see how stupid our leaders. Forming Malaysia is one of the three. bread, Sabah, Sarawak, and Malaya. Then we call it Malaysia. We are not Malay, what we call Malay Federation. But what we see now, I see now, we are Malay Federation. It's not Malaysian Federation. If you are talking about we are Malaysia, that means Sarawak is having its own negara. I mean Sabah have its own negara, right? And Sarawak is having its own negara also. Because we are three partners. Because our first governor is negara, is not Yang Dipertuan Negeri, Yang Dipertuan Negara. Meaning, Sabah is negara. I don't know about Sarawak. Same, right? Same. So now, what can we Sabahan expect? Day by day, the orang asal, I am orang asal, the real people of Sabah, the authentic people of Sabah, become smaller and smaller. Why? Just because of Dato' Haris. Just because of Mahathir. Through approving all the citizenship and IC. So, to be exactly to know the figure, yang berbahagia Dr. Chong Leong will deliver this correct figure. But anyway, I don't want to make it time long because I want my time to give it to him because his figure is more important than mine. But one thing, I would like to convey to your people. 20 point, as what Haris said, is no more. Karena talan. We have another one, is Batu Sumpah. Ever heard Batu Sumpah? No. Okay. The Batu Sumpah is one of the agreement agreed by the Malaysian government. Kerajaan Malaysia jamin with 3 points. Religion, tanah, hak-hak tanah, right? And what do you call that one? Adat rasam.
Adat
istiadat. Only 3. So, it's the vision of our leaders named by G.S. Sunda. She has a vision. Because she's not pandai, you know. What he wanted, and I was with him before he died. He called me to the house. And he called this Donald Stephen is stupid orang putih. You know why? One thing, he wanted to stay with the Pasok Momogun. With the Pasok Momogun, the Pasok is the Kerajaan Dusun people, and the Momogun are the Chinese people. So it was very strong party that time, Pasok Momogun. But then come with the Batu Sumpah, which they never trusted the 20 points. So the vision of Sunan and all the interior people put into Batu. Batu means the agreement between the Malaysian government and the people of the interior. So written there. And since the 20 point now is look like none in the Federation of Malaysia. There's none, right, Webby? In the 20 points is no more in the Federation of Malaysia. 20 point no more. But we have the Batu Sumpah. So that our Sabahan proud of. Where it is being recorded, dipersetujukan, and it is being kept. And we can read. The Batu Sumpah, as what people said, is only a monument. It's not a monument. Mind you believe me or not? If you make something wrong, believe me or not, the Batu Sumpah may take it cost. See? Because it being Sumpah, oath stone, it's not the Tugu Peringatan, you know? As what this woman by the name of Nancy, Nancy Sukri, Ranti Sukri kami ada doing. They said, oh, this is only monument. I hope he can come to Keningau. Then I will bring our babalian. See what his life will become. Anybody don't believe Opa Tusumpa? You tell me here. You believe the Batu Sumpa is can cause you a curse? Curse, you know. So that we are fighting for the Sabahan people, fighting for. We are fighting for our right as a Sabahan. We are fighting for our heart, the right, and the fighting equality. Malaya, Sarawak, and Sabah as a three partner. So, many of Batu Sumpah will be coming up. Many. So, the thing is that, why now things are going, everything can come up unpredicted. There must be reason why Malaysia is so bad luck. Yeah? Don't you know that? Malaysia is a bad luck country. You see, even the plane go fly, then you don't know where it goes. Fly nowhere. So, believe me or not? So, saudara, saudari, we thank you. And hopefully, Sabah has no more hope, actually. If you are talking about PRU-14, it's a very big question mark. Big question mark. Because we are overpowered by the orang asing. They call it in, what is PTI. So in Semenanjung, you can have how many races? Indian, Chinese, Malay, any other what? Race and Semenanjung? No, like 3 or 4. But you want to know that how many races in Sabah? How many ethnic? You don't know. We have 27 ethnic bangsa in Sabah. Yeah. So but then, we are united. During that time, we don't fight, we don't. Even Prime Minister Razak, Najib said that. To be one Malaysia, the example is Sabah. Have you read that? Have you mentioned that? He did. Yes, indeed. But come with Mahathir, Sabah become upside down. When the religions come in, manipulating of the power and what? Ever UMNO means that UMNO is United Malay National Organization, right? So Sabah tidak ada Malay. Tapi Mahathir boleh buat yang dusun boleh jadi UMNO. And not only that, Ketua Menteri pun boleh geler-geler. 2 tahun. Sedangkan, you know, Ketua Menteri, udah kalau dia kena, vote of no confidence, 5 tahun. But Mahathir can make. See how smart this fella? But, how cunning is this fella? So, our leaders wanted always to be number one, menjadi menteri, ketua menteri, jump out from BBS, make BBRS, make PDS, make CPP, so that how our Hugon Chau collapse. Well, anyway, brothers, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not going further into that, so to you all, thank you for listening. Maybe my what is not properly arranged or whatever. Thank you, and hopefully one day you will help us in prayer or mouth-to-mouth tell. Maybe our Samananyo here get more seat in a PRU 14. So I think you save Sapa in that way. So, selamat berjuang. Terima kasih. Thank you.